Hello friends, welcome back to the channel. Today's video is going to be very interesting because today we are going to know about very useful plugins for Visual Studio Code. Actually, I used to develop my code on pycharm community edition, but now as I am getting to know more about VS Code, I am loving it. So while working on it, I got some of the craziest features available for VS Code. So I thought, let's create a video on this and share with you guys. So let's start. So our very first feature is notebook. Yes guys, many of us love working on Jupyter notebook, and now VS Code has its own notebook. Let me show you how you can have a notebook into your VS Code editor. So our plugin name is pycharm. Yes, it seems very odd, but this is the only plugin which we have. And now how you can install it into your VS Code, let me show you that. So this is my VS Code editor. And what you need to do, you just need to go this last option, and this is the option to install the extensions, or you can say the plugins. And here you need to search for pycharm, and here we have this plugin. What you need to do, you just need to hit on install, and yes, it's installed. And here is the description of this extension, and you can read it. There is another way without installing this. What you need to do, you just need to save the current Python file as ipynb, which is ipy Python extension, and nb is the notebook extension. This is the best way which I have to learn this extension, right? So let's go to our directory, and here I'm going to create a file, and I'm giving it as notebook.ipynb. And hit enter, and yes, we got this file, right? And now here I am giving name equals to try to catch, enter. Oh, right, now here let me just print it and run it. Okay, nothing is printed. Okay. So actually I didn't run this line of code. So let me just run it first. And after that I'll run this. Okay, so we got some error. So data science library ipy kernel is not installed. So if you get this error, then you need to install this extension also. So I'm going to install it. And below of it, we are having Jupyter kernel cannot be started from Python 3.7, and what is the actual error here? Let me just maximize it. Okay, so starting original kernel, error module notebook not installed. Okay, fine. So let's just have it. So yes, here we have the name error. Now let me just run it again. It's done. Now I'm running it, and yes, we are getting the print as try to catch. So like this, you can just do your things. Import date time. If I'll import, then run, then date time dot date time, and then I'll have now and run it. And yes, we are getting the date time also. So this is working same as we are working with Jupyter notebook. So this is the thing how you can install notebook, right? And just I'm pressing Ctrl S, and you can import this file into your Jupyter notebook also, right? Now let's see what is our next feature. So our next feature is autodoc string, right? So this is also a extension which you need to install into your VS Code editor. What it does, so it generates Python doc strings. Now let's get more into it. So I'm going back to my editor, and here I am going to close this. This is also, and here I'm going to search for autodoc string and just select it. And here is a GIF file where you get to know more about it. So this is a function, all the information about the function, it will automatic generated. How you need to do this? So let me first install it. And below of it, we have all the descriptions, features, and doc string formats also. So in the format of Google NumPy, you can just select from the settings, right? So let me just show you how it will work. So I'm going to file and I'm going to create a file name test.py, and here I'm going to create a function def hello world, and I'm giving a argument and print message. Right now I want to give the description of this function. So for that, what I need to do, I just need to have three times this double inverted comma and hit enter. And yes, we have the doc strings. So here you just need to define all the things. So message, and sorry, this will be as a string, and here you will define the description. So this argument will have message from user, right? So there is nothing to type manually. All the things are done by itself by using the auto doc string extension, right? So this is the another feature which we have in our VS Code. Now let's see what is next feature available for the VS Code. So the last feature is AREPL. Yes, it is sounds weird, but yes, this is the only thing which we have. And frankly speaking, I didn't research more on this, but as far as I got the information, what it stands for, it's a real-time evolution of Python language. If you have any information about its full form or any other things, please let me know in the comment section. This plugin gives you the output of your code while coding it, so you don't need to run your code every time to see the output. Now let's see how to get this into your VS Code. So let's get back to the VS Code, and again going to extension, and here I am looking for AREPL, and we must get something, yes, here, and we need to install it, right? So I am hitting on install, and after installing we must have this icon, and this is the GIF showing how this plugin will work. As you can see here, they are writing the code and the output is coming here, right? And below of this all are the descriptions how this plugin works. And the main thing which we need to see first, make sure you have Python 3 installed. So this plugin will only work for the Python 3, not for the Python 2. So as we have already installed it, now let's see how this plugin works. So in test, I'm deleting this, and here you can see we have the icon and I'm clicking on it, and it will open another file by the name having AREPL test.py, and here I'm going to run some commands, or you can say I'm going to code. So name equals to Akhilesh, and here name Akhilesh is not defined, right? Because I need to give string. So before having this plugin, we need to run this code, and after that we are having the error. But having this extension, we are getting real-time execution, you can say, or we are having all the error or outputs while doing the coding, right? So I have defined this variable and I'm going to print this name, right? As here you can see, we are getting print output as Akhilesh, and variable we have defined name Akhilesh. If I'll define one more variable 32, and here you can see variables we have defined age and name, and output only the name. And if I'll print age also, so we are getting. So let me just make it more convenient to read. My name is, and age is, and dot format this, and like here, yeah. So here you can see my name is Akhilesh and age is 32. So this is the thing which we can have by using the AREPL extension. So friends, that's it for this video. These are the some of the plugins which I wanted to show you so that you can improve your coding skills and the efficiency. If you really enjoyed this video, please hit the like button. And if you have any question related to the video, you can comment down in the comment section. To support my channel, please subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon to get notified for every new video. Thank you for watching. Jai Hind.